Good morning, guys.
Hey, good morning,
Paul. Can you open?
Hey, man, how are you?
Very good. How are you, guys? Come on, guys, Jean Lepard with me. Come to Rufo House. Welcome.
Hey, thanks, Rufo.
Come inside. I will prepare one coffee. You wanna try?
Yes, good.
Okay, I have already done. So just make a coffee, put the coffee. Okay.
Oh, what a nice rag.
Yeah. Okay, I put a coffee.
So Rufo, can I ask you the first question?
Yeah.
How was the feeling getting back to the beach?
Was amazing because long time didn't play with the team, almost 1 year. So to play again with my team and feel again football and feel important was amazing. Let's sit there in the table.
Hey, thanks, man.
You wanna try?
Some sure, whiskey? Sure.
Okay, go ahead.
It's good. So, Rufo, assisting Brandon's winning goals against Pahang. Tell us about that.
Ah, yeah. Imagine 1 year I didn't play with the team, so this is my first game, almost in 1 year. So when I come inside, I feel very, very exciting and very proud of me because I worked very hard to come back again. So this action was in the almost 2 or 3 minutes before to finish the game. So I get the ball in the middle. I see Brendan running behind the defender. So I just pass in the middle. And when I see Brendan to get the ball and cross the ball, I say, wow, when we win this game, it's the best start for me. After 1 year, give the ball to assist Brendan and winning the game. So it was the best of what I think to start the game.
Okay, Rufo, last year was a real downer for you, but your confidence in the pitch is sky high for this season. Share with us your journey and motivation.
Yeah, last year was very sad for me because after 2018, getting the Golden Boot, the best player import in Malaysia, I was very excited to start the 2019 season. So in the fifth game against Kuala Lumpur, I remember when I make a jump, when fall down, I feel something broken. You know, I feel like one sound very hard. So I asked for the defender, when you fall down, you touch me? He say no, but I feel something. So when I awake, I put my leg in the field and I don't have power, you know? So I feel very, very weird. So this is not the worst. The worst coming next day, when the doctor tell me I have broken my Achilles tendon. So I ask, how long? And he tell me almost 5 to 8 months. So I say, wow, I finished the season. So, okay, after 1 month, I start to maintain my mentality strong. I start to work in the gym, doing strengthening, everything. But in September, 9th of September, I have the worst news for myself. I lost my dad. So, was in two ways. The worst not news for me, because I lost my dad. But after this, I feel something special inside of me. And I work more hard because now I want to show him and I want to him to be proud of me. So now everything I'm doing is because him, and I know he is watching this. Man, we will drink this fast because I need to do workout in the gym.
Okay, sure, bro.
Okay. So you can follow. I will take some stuff for doing the gym. This is my room. Yeah. Ah, this one. Yeah, I'm studying finance from Spain. I'm doing online course. So, yeah, every day I'm doing this, studying about 2-3 hours and keeping my mind busy, you know, because for this pandemic, every day at home is very hard. So with this, unless I can feel busy, you know. So if no is a problem for you, I will change. I see you back.
Okay, bro.
Okay.
Same time.
Okay, thank you. See you now. See you now.
So Rufo, what do you have time to ask about food? What food will remind you of Malaysia and your hometown?
Oh. When I'm here, I miss a lot the Spanish omelette. The name is tortilla de patata and paella. But I will miss a lot my two favorite things here in Malaysia. This is the roti canai and nasi lemak. This I will miss a lot. Oh, common things you have a lot. The people is so friendly. The families go out to have dinner, lunch. This is very common on Spain. And the most common is the fanatic of the fans, the supporting the team, like Real Madrid, Atletico Madrid, and you can find here like Selangor, Johor, Pahan. So for me, these three things is the most common on Spain.
Three years in Asia before.
Yeah.
And your home base is Selangor along the years. Share us your day one experience here in Malaysia and also in Selangor.
Oof. Before to come here, I have my ticket flight to fly to Spain from Hong Kong. I just finished my season, so I received one call from one agent, and then he tell me Selangor want you, so you must come tomorrow. I say, I already finished my season. I need to see my family, so let me go there, and then maybe in 10 days come back. He say, no, the team start this week, so you must come now. I say, okay, I come to Malaysia. So I remember I come at night, I go to Blue Wave Hotel here in Shah Alam and waiting to start the training next day. But I don't know nothing about Selangor, I don't know nothing about this agent. I say, what happened? So a bit nervous, you know, but after 5 days, finally, I go to play with Selangor. I start to train. But when I go for the training ground, I see maybe around 30 players, new players, and they are not in the team. So I feel, I'm doing trial with Selangor. So when I ask, they say, oh yeah, you must try here because they need to check you are not injured. So you must try. I say, okay, I just come already. So I can do myself. I have confidence on me, so I am doing the trial. Finally, I'm happy because I signed and you can see now 3 years here. I feel this is my team, my family. I feel I want to finish here. So very happy. Hello guys, I want to show you the heart of Selangor club. This is our training ground, and I want to show you where I signed my first agreement with Selangor. One day before to close the window, I finally get the agreement with the coach in the parking. So it was very weird, but amazing and good to remember.
Okay, Rufo, where did you see in Selangor, see your first day here, now and the future?
Oh, a lot of difference. I just came in 2017. If you see the changing room on the field, the facilities is not like now. The situation changed a lot. The field, the changing room. Now we have a good changing room. We have living room for the players to take a coffee before the training. We have also a gym area for the players to warm up before the training. So for me, changed a lot. Now it's a professional club, and of course, for my future, I feel it's something inside of me with this club. It's like my family. They give me the best from the first day. So I wish one day I can be a coach in this team. Will be my dream, and doing something great for this team.
Okay, Rufo. Second question for you.
Yeah.
League top scorer, best foreign player, both in the same year. Is there any best moment you can share with us?
Yeah, I have three of my best memories here in Selangor. My first one was in 2018, when we get to go to the final to play against Pahang in Bukit Jalil. And two of my also best memories was in Salam. My first game, because I'm starting to play at home in Salam Stadium. This is one of my best memories. And also when I won the Sultan Cup with Selangor against Singapore, I think this is my favorite or the best three memories of Selangor.
Okay, all the fans of Red Giants, we really wanted to know this. The journey of you making history here in Selangor. Share with us, bro.
Oh, it's long history. I just come to Malaysia 5 days before to close the window, so very hard to sign. Already I think I signed the contract, but it's not true. When I come here, I see when I come to the field, the team of Selangor, 25 players, but we are also 30 new players, and we don't know each other, and I say, oh, I think I don't sign my contract with Selangor. I just come for trial. So I feel a bit bad, you know? I feel a bit sad, but I say, okay, I'm here. Okay, I have confidence on myself. So, okay, let's try. So in the second day, we are not 30, we are 15 players. So I get the second step. And in the last day, imagine we are two players, me and another other striker from Russia. And this guy is very tall, very strong, 2 meters. So I say, I don't know. Maybe they choose the other guy. But end of the training, just come the captains to me, and Radman, Rasman, Uka, Rizal, Fairoz, and tell me, you are happy here? I say, yes, of course. I just come to Malaysia to play in Selangor, so I want to sign, but tomorrow finish the window, so I don't know. So they say, okay, wait. And they go inside the coach room and say, hey, coach, the tall guy is strong, okay, he's a good player, but this guy is different. So you must get take Rufino, because they will help us a lot. So sign him or now. Me, I don't know nothing in that moment, right? So I change my clothes, I go home. But between go home, I'm in the parking talking with the agent. So Manian, the coach, asked me, hey Rufo, why you are here? I say, hey, because I just come to sign with Selangor, and tomorrow finish the window.
and I don't know nothing about my contract. I don't know nothing. Tomorrow I have my flight to Spain. So he say, okay, you tomorrow go to the office and sign your contract. I say, really? He say, yeah. Tomorrow you sign the contract. And then I feel like very, very happy, you know, because I think in that night I will go to Spain and I will not sign in Selangor. So this is my first memory in the first day in Selangor.
Thank you to you guys to come and watch this interview. And I hope to see you soon in Salam and supporting the team. And I hope this year we can give for you guys one trophy.